The main challenge we have is to bridge this gap between the courtroom and the affected community. We have some difficulties even. Imagine that there is a trial. It is our objective to ensure that people know how the trial works here. It is not currently the case in Uganda because we don't have a trial, but in the case of Congo. Mm. So the affected communities have to know what happens here. The problem we have is that our staff members don't, the field offices of the court do not have the capacity to follow by internet the proceedings. Because, as you know, I mean, in Uganda it's better, but in most of the African countries, the speed of internet is low. I mean, it is not very high. So you can sit in front of the computer, but still, you know, the image is frozen continuously, and to follow the trial the whole day, it is nearly impossible. So we have a person here, a lawyer, who's an expert on communications, who follows the proceedings. And we do two things. Again, it is not a concrete case of Uganda. I don't know if you want to talk about Uganda in concrete, but because we have a trial in Congo, I want that you explain, to use a very practical example that you understand how we work. We have a person here who follows the proceedings. And then, at the end of the day, he picks up the phone, he contacts the filo, and they explain to them what happened here. At the end of the week, we produce, and this is mainly also for Congo, because of the limited resources again, we produce a summary for video and for television, which is used, for video and for radio, which is used not only to be broadcasted by the local televisions or the local radios, but also to be used by our outreach team to go to the affected communities, to the local, to the villages, and to show to them how a hearing looks like in the Hague. To get that trust, talking with the leader, to the paramount leaders, to the religious leaders, to the community leaders, to every leader which was relevant, religious leaders of course, going through the different villages, taking into account the different ethnicities, the different languages, of course, in the case of Uganda, we have a staff members who speak the different languages actually, most of the languages, the local languages of the areas where we are working. And then we started very slowly, and we were very criticized at that time, because everyone thought that we can arrive and say, hello, I'm the court, and that's important. So we started very slow, and we organize a small meeting, and we put a lot of energy and time, because you know